Welcome to my channel. Now we are going to solve one Fourier series problem. Okay, exponential Fourier series of half wave rectified signal. So already the half wave rectified sine waveform we solved, but in the trigonometric Fourier series. But now we are going to find the exponential Fourier series representation of the half wave rectified signal. Okay, and also we are going to draw the magnitude and phase spectrum. So you see, this is the given half wave rectified signal. Okay, so this one is a half wave rectified signal. So in this half wave rectified signal, so you know what is half wave rectified signal? During the positive half cycle of input signal, the output is available. During the negative half cycle of AC input signal, the diode is not conducting, so we will get the zero value. Okay, so this is said to be the half wave signal. Okay, so only positive cycles will come. During the negative cycle, zero value will come. Okay, this is the half wave rectified. So for this waveform, we are going to obtain the exponential Fourier series. Okay, so so what is the first thing? We have to identify one complete cycle. So which one is a one complete cycle? This positive as well as the zero value. Okay, this is said to be the one complete cycle. So you see, what is one complete cycle? After this cycle, again and again, the same waveform is repeating. Okay, so the time taken to complete this full cycle, it is called as the time period T naught. Okay, time period T naught. So here in our problem, so you see this point is, this is zero, this one is pi, this is 2 pi. So what is the fundamental period T naught? T naught is equal to 2 pi. Okay, T naught is equal to 2 pi or T naught. The signal is having the maximum amplitude A. Okay, so we identified the T naught value. And what is the next thing? We have to mathematically represent this half wave signal. So what is the mathematical representation for this one cycle waveform? So already you know the x of t equal to a sine omega naught t for the time t between only 0 to t naught by 2. So you see, we will get the sine wave, that is half sine wave during the time 0 to t naught by 2. For the time t naught by 2 to t naught, we will get the zero amplitude. Okay. So x of t equal to a sine omega naught t for the time t between 0 to t naught by 2. For the time t between t naught by 2 to t naught, the signal is having zero value. Okay, this is the mathematical representation of the given waveform. And the next one, we are going to represent the signal in exponential Fourier series. So you may write the exponential Fourier series formula. So in exponential Fourier series representation, any signal x of t, it can be represented as summation n equal to minus infinity to infinity cn e power j n omega naught t. So instead of omega naught, what is omega naught? 2 pi by t naught. So you may write like this or like this. Okay, both only. Okay, instead of this omega naught, here we are substituting 2 pi by t naught. Okay, this is the exponential Fourier series representation. So in this, we have to find out the value cn. So this cn is said to be the Fourier series coefficient. Okay, so what is the value, how to calculate this cn? So the Fourier series coefficient cn is calculated as that. The formula for cn is that 1 divided by t naught integration over 1 cycle period x of t e power minus j n omega naught t into dt. Okay, so here we have to substitute the value of t naught and omega naught. So for this problem, the t naught is a t naught only. And omega naught is a omega naught only. Okay. So cn equal to 1 divided by t naught. Then we have to substitute the x of t. So what is the expression for x of t? The x of t equal to a sine omega naught t for the time t between 0 to t naught by 2. So that's why the integration limit we have to restrict to 0 to t naught by 2 a sine omega naught t into e power minus jn omega naught t into dt. Okay. So here a is a constant, so you take it outside. So integration sine omega naught e power minus j omega naught t dt. Okay, so how to perform this integration? So here the variable t is available in e power also, sine theta also. Okay, so in order to integrate this one, so we may substitute instead of this sine omega naught t, okay, instead of sine theta, we may use in the structure of e powers. Okay, so already you know the thing, sine theta equal to e power j theta minus e power minus j theta divided by 2j. Okay, so you know the formula, you know. So similarly, the sine omega naught t, it can be represented as e power j omega naught t. E power j omega naught t minus e power minus j omega naught t divided by 2j into e power minus jn omega naught t dt. So here this 1 by 2j is a constant. So you take it outside. Then you add this e power with this one and a minus of this with this one. So if you are combining e power j omega naught t, e power minus jn omega naught t, which one is common? J is common. Omega naught is common, t is common. So you may write e power minus j omega naught t as a common. We have to write n minus 1. Okay, so here n is available. Here 1 is missing. So n minus 1. Similarly, if you are combining these two e power minus of e power minus j omega naught t as a common, we have to write n plus 1. Okay, into dt. Okay, then next thing. We have to integrate each term. So if you are integrating this e power, we will get e power minus j omega naught n minus 1 t divided by this constant j omega naught n minus 1. Similarly, minus of, if you are integrating this one, e power minus j omega naught n plus 1 t divided by the constant minus j omega naught n plus 1 with the limit 0 to t naught by 2. Okay. So here, you just substitute the upper limit. Okay. So instead of this small t, we have to substitute the upper limit t naught by 2. So e power minus j omega naught n minus 1 t naught by 2 by that term. Then similarly, the second term, then minus of the lower limit. If you are putting lower limit 0 means e power 0, 1. So 1 by this term, then minus of minus plus 1 by minus j omega naught n plus 1. Okay. So the next thing, so here you see, instead of in this term, omega naught and t naught is in multiplication is there. So what is the product of omega naught into t naught? The omega naught means it is 2 pi by t naught. So 2 pi by t naught into t naught cancel. So the omega naught value is a 2 pi. So that in 2 pi, that 2, this 2 cancelled. Okay. So the product omega naught t naught by 2 answer is pi. Okay. Simply pi. So e power minus j pi n minus 1. Okay, you see omega naught, the t naught by 2, the product is pi. Since omega naught can be written as 2 pi by t naught. So 2 pi by t naught into t naught by 2 means 2 cancel, t naught cancel, we will get pi. Okay, similarly here also e power minus j pi n plus 1. Okay, with this thing. And you see in the denominator, in all denominator minus j omega naught is a common. So you take it outside. Okay, then after that you take LCM. Okay, no terms are cancelling. You just take LCM. So if you are taking LCM, okay, or you combine these two things, you combine and this term, you just combine. So we have to write like this. Okay, so here you see before that the J into J, it is J squared minus 1 minus of minus plus. Okay. Similarly, the product 2 t naught into omega naught, it is converted into 4 pi. Okay. So you see, this is the Cn equation. So in the Cn, so we have to find out the value of this e power j minus j pi n minus 1. E power minus j pi n plus 1, we have to calculate. So e power minus j pi n minus 1 and e power minus j pi n plus 1, the answer is 1. Okay. If n is odd. Okay. You see, you substitute here. If n is odd value means, so we will get odd number of j pi. So odd number of j pi means the e power minus j pi, it can be written as cos pi minus sine pi. So sine any pi is 0. Cos pi is cos odd number of pi is minus 1. Cos even number of pi is plus 1. Okay. So here, so if this n value, if this n value is odd means you just consider n is a 3. Okay. So 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 2. So we will get even number of e power. So we will get the answer as plus 1. Okay. So if n is odd, this e power value will be plus 1. And n is even, this e power value, it will be minus 1. Okay. So if n is odd means, in this, you just substitute in the Cn formula, you substitute these two value. So if you are substituting, we will get a by 4 pi. There is n is odd means what is the value? This term is 1, this term is also 1. Okay. So 1 by 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 means 0. Here also 1 minus 1, 0. So for n is odd, this Cn component, it will be 0. If n is even, this both thing, it have the value minus 1. So that's why this first term can be written as minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 by n minus 1. Then minus of minus 2 divided by n plus 1. Okay. So if you are taking LCM, we will get the Cn component is a by pi into n squared minus 1. Okay. So this is the Fourier series coefficient for the half wave rectified signal when n is even. For n is odd, the coefficient Cn will be 0. Okay. So we calculated the exponential Fourier series coefficient. So after calculating the exponential Fourier series coefficient, we may substitute this Cn value in equation number 1. Okay, so you see the Fourier series representation. In this means, we will get the Fourier series representation. Okay, and in the question, they are asking draw the magnitude spectrum. Okay, magnitude spectrum we have to draw. So what is mean by magnitude spectrum? The magnitude spectrum is nothing but for modulus of Cn versus the different n value, we have to draw the graph, means it is magnitude spectrum. And the phase spectrum is nothing but the angle pi n versus various values of n, that is said to be the angle spectrum. So the phase spectrum is nothing but turn inverse of imaginary of Cn divided by real of Cn. So you see the Cn term. So here the Cn is having only real component, no imaginary component. That's why the phase spectrum is always zero. Okay, so for this problem, the phase spectrum is zero for any value of n. So the magnitude spectrum is, you see, the Cn value is purely real. So that's why the Cn value is a modulus of Cn. So modulus of Cn equal to a by pi into n squared minus 1 if for n is even. Okay, so for a different value of the n value, okay, for fundamental frequency, we have to draw the thing. Okay, so you just make one table. So if n is, okay, you put n equal to 0. So if you are substituting n equal to 0, what is the answer? A divided by minus pi, that is modulus. Okay, we have to substitute the modulus value. So for modulus value means the answer is a by pi. Okay, you see, at n equal to 0, the signal is having the maximum Cn value a by pi. Okay, similarly, if n equal to even, so even means 2. So put n equal to 2. So here 2 means 2 squared, 4. 4 minus 1, 3. So what is the modulus of Cn? A divided by 3 pi. So the amplitude is, this is A by 3 pi. Okay, this height is A divided by 3 pi. At the frequency n equal to 2. Okay, so similarly at n equal to minus 2 also, A by 2, 3 pi. Okay, the same magnitude. Similarly at n equal to 4 means we will get A by 5 pi. And so if you are increasing the n value, the coefficient, the Fourier series coefficient decreases. Okay, the amplitude decreases. Okay, this is the magnitude spectrum of our half wave rectified signal. Okay, and the phase spectrum is just zero. Okay, since the phase spectrum, that is the Cn value is not at all having any imaginary part. So that's why the phase spectrum, pi n value is zero. So for any value of n, what is the phase spectrum? Okay, so if you are drawing the phase spectrum for different frequency means all phase angle is 0 only. Okay, 0, 0 only. This is the phase spectrum pi n. Okay, so this is the magnitude spectrum and this is the angle spectrum. Okay, so that's all this question. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos and keep watching. Thank you.